Hey, what's up, SaaS Masters? My name's George, and I'm really excited to show you Google Tables that just launched. So right now, it's in a beta form, so you can only see it if you're in the United States. But I'll give you a quick tip. If you use a VPN making it think you're in the United States, you can actually use it. You don't need to create a brand new Google account, just use the one you have already. So Google Tables is actually free, you don't have to pay anything, and they have a paid version if you need more tables than what it already gives you. So it's only $10 for the paid version monthly, so I don't think it's that bad. And what I think Google is trying to go after Airtables, because that's the kind of the most closest competitor I can think of. I think it's not there yet, but that's why they're in beta mode right now. So you can do automations, you can do to-do list, you can use Kanban view, and it's really, really cool. Now, you don't confuse this with Google Sheets. This is way different. Google Sheets is more like the formula and that really nasty looking like sheets, like you've seen it always. And Google Tables is way more advanced, looks way nicer, and I'm gonna show you that right now. So really check it out. The link will be in the description if you want. Like I said, it's free. There's no affiliate thing or anything going on there. Just wanna show you that this is a cool tool that you can use right now. So let's jump over to my desktop and show you how easy it is to actually use it. So let's go over there. All right, this is the Google Tables site, and like I said before, I am using a VPN to make it think I'm in USA. Now, really quickly, I want to show you their pricing tables. Like I said, they have a free version and a paid version. The free version gives you up to 10 tables, 1,000 rows per table, 1 gigabyte of attachments, that's per table also, 50 actions, and they have a limited history sharing form creation automation. So they have some limits there that are not so clear, but for example, you can add the automations that are called bots. You can only add 2 per table. That's one of the limitations that I found, but they should be more clear right here. But remember, they are in beta stage right now, so there's a whole lot of information that might change. And if you need more, there's a paid version that costs $10, just in case you wanna grab that. Okay, so let's jump into my Google Tables site. This is my dashboard right here, and let me show you really quickly a to-do list right here, and show you the Kanban view. So let me go like that. And this is a view from Google Tables. Now, this has nothing to do, you can see, from Google Sheets. You cannot do it on Google Sheets, because first of all, you can't drag and drop. You can't like update what it does if you drag it this way. See how that update into errands instead of fam? So all that good stuff. And you can do accounting, like tables, a whole lot of things you could do that are so advanced that you couldn't do on Google Sheets. Now, let me give you like an overview of what this is. Let's just say, for example, you are using Monday, which is a popular app, and you only see like the nice view, right? You only see drop-down menus, you see some boxes where you can add the information, but you can't edit what it actually does. And with Google Tables, you can actually edit on the back end what you want it to do. So you have that like developer access, you can give that kind of sense with it. So you have more options with this than you would do with an app that's already built, and you can only do what they tell you or what they added as a developer. So this way you can do a lot of editing, and for example, for accounting, you can do your own formulas and do kind of good stuff that will automate more than you would do with other apps. All right, so before we jump into automation, let me build a really quick to-do list for you guys so you see how easy this actually is. So I'm gonna click on this new button right here, and we can create a blank workspace, which means you can separate your workspaces. So for example, one business or a second business, or just separate the workspace, like this is marketing workspace, this is the accounting workspace, and you can separate it that way. Whoops, I didn't wanna create a workspace. Okay, let's go back. In this case, I'm gonna create one blank table, okay? This is a blank table, kinda looks like Google Sheets, but it's not. All right, so this brand new one, we're gonna call it to-do, all right? That's gonna be to-do one, and you can select the type of area this is going to be, this role right here. So this is a text one, that's okay. Next one is going to be the, click on this, status, all right? And this one's gonna be a drop-down. We're gonna click done, we're gonna click again 2 times, the right click and do the edit. And we're gonna add the drop down option. So in this case, it's gonna be pending, process, canceled, and pending process and working. Okay, so the canceled, I'm gonna change the color to red, and working would be yellow, kind of yellowish, that's okay. And pending would be yellow, like that. All right, you could do whatever you want, but these are just examples, and done. All right, and the third column, we can delete it if we want by deleting column, but we're actually gonna set it up a little bit for later on for the automation. So this is gonna be assignee, and this is going to be based on person. Done. Okay, let me click on that. And if we click back again on assignee, we can add people right here. So for example, I added two just for testing purposes. You can add other emails or the names as you want. It's better to add emails because we're gonna do automation with it. Okay, so we got the to-do list. What am I gonna do? All right, so it's make video. Work on description, delete old video, and just whatever you want, right? This could be for a paint job, for painting your car, or doing whatever for your work, or marketing, accounting, and the statuses are right here. We can update the status if we want, whatever we want right here, by doing it from the table, or we can actually do it from the Kanban. So let's jump into the Kanban view right here, Kanban board layout. And this is where we can add the drag and drop like I told you. So for example, we got the no status right here. So make a video that would be in pending. And if we want to add this one, for example, this could be in work on description. That could be a process. And if we want to delete old video, that could be in working, or just say, you know what, that was canceled. And we set one as we wanted, like just drag and drop really quickly. Let's go back to the other view, the grid layout, and you can see the same statuses that I gave them on the Kanban. We can update them right here if we want. Now for the assignee, let's just say we wanna do an automation. So in this case, we're gonna go into bots right here, and we can do different type of bots. So for example, we can select a trigger. What do you want to do with the trigger? Is it gonna be based on the column value, like we're gonna do right now? It could be time-based, depending on what time you wanna use, the row added, or row removed. So if you remove something, it's gonna do a trigger. In this case, it's gonna be a value, and it's gonna be in status. And if the status is changed, we are going to send it to an email right here. So by the email, we're gonna assign a variable right here. So it could be the email address is optional if you want it to be like sent by. But in this case, who is it gonna be sent to? So in this case, it's gonna be by the assignee. All right, that's who it's gonna be assigned to. So the assignee has an email tag to it. So that's how it's gonna be sent. And in this case, the subject of the email. So it's gonna be take a look, dash, and a variable right here. We can add a variable with a column or based on a variable that they have. So for example, we'll use that in a bit. So this one's based on a column, and this is gonna be the to-do. So that's what the, it's gonna add it, whatever it says right here, it's gonna be added right there. And the email bot is gonna be like, hello, take a look at, and again, we're gonna add that variable from a column, and it's gonna be to-do. And then we are going to say what the status is, just gonna give that information, and it's also gonna be based on a column. So it's gonna be the status. And at the end is, check it out here, all right? Check it out here. And this one's gonna be unavailable from here. So we're gonna, you can select one of these because depending what you want, right? So it's gonna be record URL. So that's gonna be the URL from right here. Let's save that bot. And that is automated, okay? That is the email. And what I'm gonna do is add the assignee, and I'm gonna change the status to activate the bot. So I'm gonna change it from process to pending, all right? So that should send out an email. Let's go back to my email. Let's refresh it, and there it is. Remember we said take a look, and the variable was the to-do. So that's work on description. Let me click on it, and here it is. Hello, take a look on work on description. So that was the to-do. The status is the pending, and here's a link to check it out. Let me click on it really quickly. And here's the status of that table. Obviously, I'm logged into my Gmail, and that is the status for me. So I can update it from here if I want, or leave it like that, whatever we want. Okay, so see how easy that was to automate? And you can do many automations right here. So let me show you another one really quickly, new bot. And you can select the trigger. So it could be based on row added. Oh, row removed, okay? Click that on that. And then we can give it more conditional options. So if the row from the assignee matches or is blank, we could say blank, select an action. We can send out an email. We can add a new role to do something. We can update a role, or we can send to a webhook. Now with webhook, if you're using Zapier, Integromat, or Pavly, or Integrately, just anything that has webhooks, you could use it that way. And you could do a whole bunch of things with it. So it's super easy to automate with all of this. Let me cancel this one because we don't want to use that. And that's how easy it is to create a to-do list. And you can go really complex with this. Now, you can do a whole lot. You can do it, add a row. You can go back, forward, check what happens. So for example, if you had assignees to here and they were using the team members, if they removed something, you could see what happened here with history. You can save the view. For example, if you want to view the first view as the Kanban instead of this one, you can do it right there. Select the grid layout, the record queen layout. You can change the, you can group this right here. I don't want to group it right now. You can filter table rows. You can set them by table rows right here, so A to Z, and adjust view density. So super easy to use. You got the bots, you got forms. If you want to create a brand new form, we're not gonna go into this in the video, and relationship. So super easy to do. Let me show you really quickly this instructional one, which is another one. And by the way, you can add more tables right here, more tabs, as you would, for example, in Google Sheets, just add a brand new tab right here, which is a new table, right? Remember, by table, you got those options by this right here from the plan. So those are based on the tables. So there you go, guys. That is Google Tables. I think it's pretty cool and awesome that they brought this out and they have a free plan with it. Hope they make it a little bit better in time. Just wait to see what happens when they get out of beta stage. And remember, if you want to see this, you need to use the VPN. And if you guys want to check it out, the link will be in the description. It's a normal link. It's not affiliate. And if you guys are not subscribed to this channel, consider subscribing. Thank you for watching. My name is George, and this is SaaS Master. I'll see you guys later.